And we have a great, thank you. We have a great show today, you know. I'm going to start gently with this gentleman. His name is Kofi Ayi, and he is into amazing products. You know what we do on this show is that we find Ghanaians who are doing great things that we need to expose and support, and this guy is one of them. He's going to be on soon. And then after that, there'll be trouble in the house, man. Maybe I shouldn't say that, but there are some feminists in the house, man. Show some love for feminists, man. You know, feminism has become an F word in Ghana, you know. If you are going to insult somebody, I won't be feminist. Well, these are a bunch of very, very, you know, beautiful. Oh yeah, maybe that's even not politically correct, though. Why are you saying we are beautiful? If it was a man, would you say he's beautiful? But anyway, we have feminists. I'll be introducing them. They are coming on after my first guest. But let's now deal with the first guest. And we are going to be talking to Mr. Kofi Ayi. And he's going to be telling us all about Adriaba Industries. Put your hands together. Show some love for Mr. Kofi Ayi. There we go. Please have a seat. Okay, he's in the house. And coming much later, I'll be introducing my dear, powerful guests that are in the house as well. But in the meantime, are we ready to start the show?
Yeah.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
Now put your hands together and say the KSM show!
The KSM show.
We are back. Thank you. Kofi, welcome to the show, man.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
You're doing great?
Yeah.
You look great. You look great.
Thank you.
Adriaba, is it Adriaba?
Yeah, Sips, this is Adriaba. Adriaba Sips and Snacks.
Sips and Snacks.
Yes.
We'll talk about Sips and Snacks very soon, because that's why we are here, you know. But before then, give me a little bit about your background. Where were you born, went to school?
Okay.
All the interesting stuff.
Okay. So I'm a Dansoman boy. I was born in Dansoman.
Oh.
Yes. And I've lived, I think, about past 25 years of my life.
In Dansoman?
Yeah.
Wow.
Dansoman.
You should be the mayor.
And then, so I went to Most Holy Heart for my junior high school and then in Fanspim for senior high school. And then I went to UCC to do biochemistry. I found myself in some great class. After a year, I ran away. Then I came to do psychology at Methodist University. Yeah, and then after doing psychology, I think I spent some time teaching and also working in the financial.
What were you teaching?
I taught subjects like English, science, math, and social studies.
Okay, yes. Okay. And at which point, what do you do? Now you have Adriaba.
Yeah.
Sips and snacks.
Snacks, yes.
It has very little to do with your biology that you...
Well...
when did that come in?
Okay, so after some time in the classroom, I decided to get into the financial institution. I worked for a while. That's a corporate world. I worked for a while. And then at a point in time, I got kind of bored, like with the thing I was doing, waking up, going to work, sitting behind the computer, especially we're given targets. And sometimes I could just sit behind the computer and at the end of the month, I've exceeded my target. Like, this is boring. And I also was thinking about the number of young people that are coming from SHS who probably might want some job to do and get some money before they go to the university. So I thought of starting up something.
Mm.
And then I thought of doing fruit juices and smoothies.
But why is that interesting, fruit juices and smoothies? Do I like from a Greek background?
I like food.
You like food?
I like food. Yes, I like food. And
do you eat a lot? You don't look like it.
I don't look like I eat a lot, but I just like combining things and then making something. So I think that interest sprung up first when I was thinking of doing something. Yes, something that could sell fast and also grow fast and then get a lot of people employed.
Mm.
Yes.
And so how did it become this?
Yes, okay. So then I was thinking, what name should I give to this? I thought about a lot of names. But there was something interesting. One morning I was thinking about a tree. And a, I was thinking, it looks like the life of it, you have a fruit, the fruit, you have a seed, you eat the fruit, you plant the seed, it becomes a tree, gives many fruits. And then, so that's sort of synchronized my idea of getting a lot of people employed and then also giving out to people like something that is fresh and natural. So then I came up with Idiaba. Idiaba in our local dialect at one point means fruit, another point means seed.
Seed, yeah.
Yes. So then I thought of it, okay, so I'm starting this business that is Idiaba. First, to nourish people, give them healthy snacks, and then also to create employment for a lot of people using the tree philosophy. Yeah.
So have you employed lots of people, or you, how many people have you employed now?
Okay, so that's interesting. I started with that enthusiasm and I employed 7 people at a go when I started the business. And then after 3 months, my business came rushing down, boom. And then I started learning lessons that if you want to employ people, you have to start from somewhere. So then I started with smoothies, salads, and then juices. I was distributing to banks and all that. So when everything went down, I started with my own investment. I lost everything.
And what caused the downfall?
So I think I was so passionate about the product and I wasn't looking at the finances of the business. And two, I was very, you know, sort of like kind person with the people I work with. So even you go and come and they haven't sold and you're nice to them and all that. And everything worked together to bring the business down.
Yeah. You couldn't take the strict business decisions.
No.
You're being the nice friend.
Nice friend, yes.
So but now you started back again and you're now business like. What was the new?
Okay. So this is what happened. I would like to link that to this product, this particular product. So then I had a shop. So I was in the shop every day because I also bottled lemon, and then honey, yes, and then other products. So I'll just go and sit in the shop, and then we'll be selling. But there was this day I had some, funny enough, I had some lemons, and then one customer who comes to get juice walks in and says, "I need something to drink," and I go like, "It's unfortunate, but I don't have anything here." Then she says, "I see lemons on the shelf. What can you do?" Then I take the lemons, I say, okay, give me a minute. Then I go to the back and then I squeeze the lemons. And then I have some ginger, so I blended the ginger. I started lemonade, but I started with sugar syrup. On this particular day, I didn't have sugar. Then I realized that, I have honey, so let me try something. Then I mixed the honey and then I brought it out to her. She took it and she loved it. Then she said, "This is great. Give me another cup." And I give her another cup. Then she went home and she came with a mug, a jug. And then I filled it for her. Then the next day, she comes with 3 jugs. And I was like, wow, okay. I think I can do something with this. So I started lemonade. And then I started advertising lemonade. Then people around started coming. Then people would start asking, "I want lemonade." Then I thought, okay, let me do the lemonade. So 9 months down the line, I advanced this product, thought of a bottle in which I want to put it in. Mm-hmm. And today, that is the product that leads my company. It's a product I'm putting out there.
So as they kept coming, you realize, well, there's a need here to fill. Wow. So how big are you now? Are you still, have you cut down your number of employees to something reasonable that you can manage? How many do you have now?
So now we are just 2.
You're 2.
We're just 2. Yeah. So along the line where I was, when I started the lemonade, then I had this lady friend who said, "Okay, you do lemonades. I also want to help you. I want to start by doing samosas so we can sell lemonades
and samosas."
And so she started working with me. And for the past 9 to 10 months, we've been working together. We haven't paid ourselves. I had to move from the shop. She spoke to her parents. They gave us their garage to set up as a place to use. And since then, we've been working together. She was supposed to be here with me today, because just to show that in the company, it's not just the guys, it's also...
Yeah, I mean, there's a partnership going on there.
She's really helped, She's really been supportive.
So are you now stable, or you're not going down again?
I would say that currently I have risen, because I had a huge debt.
Yeah.
I've managed to settle my debts, and now I've started on a fresh page. So I've started, and I do about... let me see, as of last month, I was doing maybe like 30 bottles a day, but now I do about 60 bottles a day, and there's shortage. So I have to even
increase output.
Yeah.
But that's how it starts, you know, and you build up incrementally, and then it gets there.
Yeah.
You know?
Sure.
Fantastic. So your outfit is in Dansoma as well?
Yes, so we are in Dansoma, and we are around Dansoman Runabout. That is where we produce from.
Yeah.
I have two friends as well who partnered in this.
Okay.
Augustine and then Kofi Asarabediakon. I mean, they've been very helpful right from the scratch.
Okay. But at the current level, if I tell you to put out a number and people are making requests, you can meet them?
Yes, I can. Yeah, there's something about my request. I always love to... I mean, from my experience, I love to tell people the truth. You come and I look at the timeline and the resources that will help me deliver within the timeline. I'll just let you know that. And that's for now, that's how I'm keeping myself. I don't want the pressure.
Okay. If you're comfortable enough and you want to put your number out for people to make requests, you can do it.
Yeah, sure. I am.
And you won't let them down?
I won't.
Okay.
I won't.
How can they contact you?
Okay, so they can contact me on 054-663-4851, and then on that number Joshua Lynn will pick up.
Okay.
Yes. And then also on 0275-883587. That's my line. You could send me a WhatsApp on that line, the 0275 line.
Okay, great. And I see the products. So it's lemonade, and what's the red one?
Okay, so all of them are lemonade. Yes, but you see here, this one is Classic G. So Classic G is was the first product I made. Lemon, honey, and ginger.
Okay.
Yes, Classic G. And then I thought of using other herbs to also sort of flavor the lemon, the lemonade. So I came up with this one called Red Citro. So Red Citro is lemon, honey, and ginger, and hibiscus, what we call sobolo leaves.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And then the last one here, this one is funny. When you produce it fresh, it looks green. And then after a while, it turns this color. This is golden mint. So golden mint is lemon, honey, and ginger with mint. And all these things are made fresh. I don't use concentrates. I have fresh lemons, fresh ginger, and then the leaves. I blend them, and then I put them together to arrive at this product.
And there it is, man. Adiaba. Products, Adiaba Simpson Snacks.
The company's name is actually... Idiaba Foods Company Limited.
Foods Company Limited,
yes,
okay.
But there is an idea for the company to have the sips and snacks, and then also to package fresh fruits and vegetables and distribute to people. We'll be doing that via an online mart, so that's Idiaba Mart. And at Idiaba, we don't like to make waste. We like to make good use of waste. So there is another part called Idiaba Recycler, where everything we use is recycled into manure and then sold back to the farmers to be used to help grow.
Wow.
Yeah.
Fantastic, man. Put your hands together. And for other startups like this that are trying, you know, if you have a product that has reached a marketable level, you know that this platform is always there for you to come and talk about them. And you can get in touch with the producer, and then we'll look at it and make sure that it's something that we want to put out, and we do it. And by the way, at no cost to you, we do it. That's our contribution to national development, man. Give it up! Keep. Okay. Thank you so much. Cigarette, folks. Coming up next, the F word. We'll be right back.
If you reach for that remote, I will bite you. The KSM Show will be right back.
The KSM Show.